Welcome back to our Blender to HitFilm Masterclass. In our last tutorial, we had gone through the tools for adding depth and detail to our cargo container. We do recommend you going through those tutorials, but if you want to just jump into this one and follow along, the HitFilm and Blender files are down in the description. In this tutorial, you can use either HitFilm Pro or HitFilm Express to follow along. We want to make sure that everyone can experiment and enjoy this tool. Just know that if you want to actually export the scene from HitFilm Express, you'll need to purchase the 3D model render add-on from the store, link in the description, or it'll render with a watermark. Let's start off by exporting our model out of Blender. First, we're going to need to triangulate our faces. This is because it's much easier to calculate and render triangles rather than quads. Yay, Pythagoras! Have your model selected and head into edit mode. We'll select all the faces by tapping A, right click, and go to triangulate faces. You can also do this from using the shortcut Ctrl and T. We're all set and cleaned up for export. Jump back into object mode and head on over to file and down to export. A new window will open and we're presented with a few options. The most common 3D file type for HitFilm is wavefront.obj and .fbx. OBJ is a much simpler format that keeps geometry and UV data. FBX is a more advanced format that can hold a lot more data, such as models, UV data, joints, skinning information, animations. We can dive into the settings of FBX another time, so be sure to subscribe and not to miss out. As this is static, let's go with wavefront.obj. Open the drop-down tabs and we'll tick selection only, and objects as OBJ objects. Under geometry, we're only going to keep right normals, include UVs, and right materials. Now we can go ahead and hit export. With our model set, let's jump into HitFilm. I have my footage open and ready in a composite shot, but before we start, we'll first need to import our model. Head on over to the import tab and hit the arrow beside it. We're going to of course choose 3D model. Find your model wherever you exported it. The import should come with textures attached. But if not, you can relink them from this icon. We're going to first sort some of these faces popping by going into Advanced tab and setting the method to Generate Faceted. We can hit Update Preview to see what we've now changed. Now let's tweak some of these material settings. Set Illumination Model to Cook Torrents for a Metal Starting Point. I dial my Roughness to about 20% and Specular to 2. For some fun customizations later, we're going to be using the new Animated Texture function. But to do this, we'll need to import the maps, which you'll need to enable from this icon beside the model name. You'll see in the media panel that a folder has been created with our original texture. Great, hit OK. Let's first prep and map out our scene. I want to keep the existing containers to act as a reference and help sell the composite. So using the freehand mask tool, I'll mask the area I want to keep. I'll speed through the masking process, but if you're new to HitFilm and this is far too fast, we have a bunch of tutorials on masking and other compositing tools to help explain this process. Once the area is masked, I'll bring in the sky image and place it underneath my footage, tweaking it into an appropriate position. There we go. We can now map out our scene. Generate a new layer and set it to 3D. A new camera will automatically be created for this scene. Apply a grid effect from the Generate drop-down of the effects window. We'll now use the Camera Orbit tool to move the camera into a similar position of our live footage, using our grid as a guide. With the grid aligned, grab our model and throw it into the scene, placing it between the sky image and our footage to keep up masking. Let's start off by positioning it above this existing one that we have here. Now in place, let's light the scene. Go to the new layer icon and create a light. As we shot this on a cloudy day, I'll be changing the type to an ambient light in order to mimic the natural lighting of this scene. Be sure to move the light beside your model for it to be affected. Let's also turn off the grid's visibility. Well, that's embarrassing. If you're like me and missed the mark a little bit, you may need to make a few alterations. I'll also adjust the intensity of the light to match the scene's exposure. Once happy with the lighting, the one thing you'll probably notice is the container's color is off, like completely off. To fix this, we're going to be customizing the textures. Let's grab the texture we imported with our model and turn it into composite shot by dragging it over the new composite shot icon. In here, we'll make the adjustments, then link it back to our model. Let's drag in our footage. This way we can take a color sample from the existing containers. I'll just make a quick mask around the area I want. Create a new plane and set the color to a mid-tone of the container. To help compare, let's keep this sample as a top layer. Enter the controls panel of the plane layer and change the blend mode to overlay. Great, that's given us a good baseline to work with. Create a grade layer and in here we'll make some adjustments.
starting off with color temperature to match the one used on the day of filming. Followed by a curves effect to raise the blacks, boost the greens, and to add a touch more blue. If we jump back into our main composite shot, we can see that nothing has changed yet. We need to link them. Select your model and go into the control panel. Open the model's dropdown and head over to Override Materials. Here we can relink material sources for our model using layers and composite shots. Drag in the material composite shot we've been working on and bring it into this timeline, placing it in the bottom of our layers. With this brought in, change the diffuse map source to use layer. A new tab has been created to select our material composite shot. Now that we have the new texture applied, I'll adjust my light intensity once again. We can now make a structure of containers by duplicating this model, Ctrl and D, then repositioning it using the axis controls. Be sure to keep the layering in this timeline to match the depth of each object to avoid overlapping. To customize a few of these containers, we can repeat the steps for the material, creating a new composite shot or duplicating the existing one, linking it to your model, then amending the material by altering the colors, or perhaps add assets like rust or logos to elevate your scene into the living world. Down in the description of this video, we have the project files available, as well as a couple of logos and assets that you can use to customize your own containers. For additional flair and compositing detail, check out our compositing tutorial playlist.
You may now be thinking, is that it from us? But no, we've got more for you. Now that we've covered the basics, made a model, and know how to composite, we're going to be learning how to do some simple physics simulations to use on your model. So be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to avoid missing out, and we will see you in the next tutorial.